Learning how to type quickly and accurately isn't easy. There are many pitfalls to dodge and schemes to avoid. One thing is for certain though, you're not going to fall for them. Here are 10 common and detrimental mistakes to avoid making when learning how to type properly. The first one is being too focused on speed. Pretty much everyone starts learning how to touch type because they want to type faster. Speed is a natural focus of touch typing right from the get-go, but focusing too heavily on speed won't make you a faster typer. Instead, focus on accuracy, and as your accuracy improves, your speed will naturally improve as well. Seriously, typing at a much slower speed and not making any mistakes is going to improve your typing much faster than rushing through sentences, making a bunch of mistakes, and messing up your muscle memory, aka setting you back in your typing skill. Focus on accuracy, not speed. Number two. Okay, I'm going to be tough on this one, but I'll give you a break on the next one. Number two is not learning the shift in punctuation keys like period, comma, and apostrophe. It's easy to get focused on learning all of the letter keys on a keyboard and being satisfied with just that, looking down each time a period comes up or every time you need to capitalize a letter. But seriously, these keys are used all the time, and you're doing yourself a great disservice by not committing them to your permanent muscle memory. Until you learn these keys, you can't practice typing full sentences, further hurting your progress at becoming a speedy typist. Okay, so I was strict on the last one. Now I'm going to give you a break. The third common mistake is focusing too much on the number keys at the top of the keyboard. That's right, if you're having trouble improving your typing skill, I'm telling you to forget about the number keys at the top of the keyboard for now, with one exception. That exception is the exclamation point. It's a good idea to practice this one as it is used quite often. Aside from that, however, focus on the letter keys and the punctuation keys that I just talked about. The number keys are used quite a bit less often and can be frustrating to master. That brings me to mistake number four, learning too many keys at once. Although it might seem like a good idea to jump right in and learn everything all at the same time, and some modern training methods actually promote this strategy, it won't work for everyone. Trying to memorize too many keys at once may make it hard to memorize any keys at all. If you have a great memory or are learning to type for the very first time and don't have any bad habits to break, the all-in methods may work for you. If you're someone who's already developed a personal typing method and you've plateaued at a certain speed, it may be easier for you to start learning letter by letter or at least finger by finger, or else your old habits will slip right back in. You're going to use your typing skills for the rest of your life. There is no need to rush it and compromise your training. Since you're in it for the long run, mistake number five is not investing in a proper keyboard. There is a huge variety of keyboards available nowadays, which makes sense when you think about the fact that we've been using the QWERTY keyboard layout since the late 1800s. So if you're going to learn how to type, you should be using a keyboard that enhances your learning. There is obviously a bit of personal preference involved, but I recommend using a mechanical keyboard like the one that you see here. This is a SteelSeries Apex Pro. With mechanical keyboards, the keys bounce back after you type a letter, giving you some touch feedback. This helps let you know that you've typed the letter properly and helps keep your fingers in the right position. Learning how to touch type on a digital keyboard or tablet isn't recommended. Although I use Mac computers quite a bit, I find the Mac keyboard much more difficult to type with and wouldn't recommend them for a beginner typist either. Once you've mastered typing all of the keys on the keyboard, you shouldn't have any problems transferring to any QWERTY keyboard and easily typing regardless of the keyboard style. Mistake number six will give you another reason to get a new keyboard. Don't overuse your smartphones. You should avoid using your smartphones for tasks that you can do on a computer when you're learning how to touch type. If your computer is nearby, use that for ordering from Amazon, looking up directions, and Googling random questions. You may benefit from the extra screen space, you will definitely benefit from the extra typing practice, and once you master the keyboard, all of these tasks will be faster on the computer anyway. No matter how you cut it, you can type faster using your 10 fingers than you can using your 2 thumbs. So curb your smartphone usage and learn how to type both at the same time. Just because you're not binging on your smartphone doesn't mean that you should make mistake number seven, binge learning. Just because I said it's better to learn each letter individually and not the entire keyboard at once does not mean you should stay up for 72 hours straight learning each letter individually and learning how to touch type in just 3 days. If you've watched my multi-part typing course, then you know that muscle memory is a huge part of typing fast and accurately, and muscle memory takes time to build. I bet that if you took those 72 hours and you spread them out over the course of 3 months instead of 3 days, that you would learn a lot more and that your typing skill would improve much more than just cramming it all down in 3 days straight. It takes time to build this muscle memory. I honestly feel like I shouldn't have to say this, but mistake number 8 is using the incorrect finger positions. I mean, seriously, if you're learning how to touch type, you have got to focus on this one. You need to make sure that your fingers are starting and ending on the home row keys and that you're using the right finger to make each keystroke. I mean, you can get by in life without doing this, but if your goal is to become a speedy typist, this is an absolute must. I mean, if your starting fingers are off, then you're going to be off for all of the other letters that you try and type outside of the home row. This is also another reason why learning the letters one by one, or at least finger by finger, is helpful. It ensures that your fingers are in the right position and that you're not creating a habit that's going to be difficult to correct later on. Okay, number 9 is a no-brainer. I know, but hear me out. Number 9 is looking at the keyboard. I know, you've read it on every blog and Reddit, and like I said, it's obvious, but it's also easy, common, and is a major setback for becoming a better typist. You should be setting aside dedicated practice sessions for touch typing, and during those practice sessions, you should be looking at the keyboard as little as humanly possible. Print out a finger chart, remember that the F and J keys have little ridges on them, so you should get used to finding the home row without looking, and for the rest of your practice session, don't look at the keyboard. This is how you learn to type fast and accurately in an efficient manner. I know that when you're doing your everyday tasks, this can be difficult, and that's fair. But during your practice sessions, no looking. Okay, I'm sure you've heard of number 10 as well, but I'm going to take it to the next level, so get ready. Mistake number 10 is bad posture. Yes, I'm talking about physical posture. Get a good chair, make sure your computer's at the right eye height, make sure your wrists are straight, all of that good stuff that you can find on any typing blog. But I'm also talking about mental posture. You see, learning how to touch type is an incredible manifestation of the human body. Our fingers moving one with our brain, expressing our thoughts, plans, and dreams as quickly as we can think of them. But many view typing as a chore. Well, I'll tell you, once you master it, there is nothing chore-like about typing. Sure, it can feel chore-like when you're learning how to touch type. That is the most difficult part. But once you get there, it's freeing, it's liberating, and it's quite fun. I mean, you can move so fast on a computer, complete tasks quicker, and be more efficient in your everyday life. So as you're learning, set a mental posture that focuses on all of the benefits of learning this skill. Be excited to learn how to type. Celebrate your accomplishments. Setting a good mental posture will surely have you sitting up straight and ready to master the keyboard. If you're learning how to touch type and haven't watched my beginner course here on YouTube, I definitely recommend that you check that out next. If you're already on your way to conquering the keyboard and are looking for a secret method to type faster than ever, then you should check out my video called Type Faster Now, where I give away a secret strategy for advanced typists to gain even more speed. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. If you want to see more typing content like this, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. I wish you speed and accuracy conquering the keyboard. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.